They're looking at people behind them, bro. Yo, one on me landed. Oh my god, I knifed him. I just fucked that kid. Let's go. Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Xbot. I hope you guys are doing absolutely wonderful today. We have some huge news to cover in this video. We're going to go over everything that we know about Verdansk coming to an end. It looks like the dam location is going to be eradicated. That's why in here in this video, this is going to be my very last time ever dropping dam in Call of Duty Warzone. So click the thumbs up button if you guys are hyped to see dam get absolutely eradicated in Call of Duty Warzone. The reason why we know there's an in-game event coming, we got another piece of intel directly from Call of Duty through a little teaser I'm going to throw up on the screen here in just a second. But also, for those of you that follow me on the Twitter or Instagram, you guys have seen me receive packages from Activision over the last several weeks that has hinted at every single location that we are going to see the zombies going to be moving. As you've been in game, you've seen zombies move all around the map. Well, on this week's package that we received with intel for what's to be coming to Warzone, it has a date. It says April 21st at 12 p.m. That's going to be at 12 p.m. Pacific time. There's going to be an in-game event in Call of Duty Warzone, and I assume that's going to be the point that Verdansk could be getting nuked or something's going to be taking over. Dam's going to be getting broken. I'm not really sure exactly, but set your calendars for that exact date. I will be live streaming it. I'm going to take some time off of work to make sure I'm able to cover that via a live stream because it's going to be a live event, and also get a video up on the YouTube channel as fast as possible. So if you guys are not following me over on Twitch, make sure you guys do follow me there. There's a link down in the description below. We'd love to have you guys become part of my Twitch community. We have been live streaming all of our random duos content, and I'm just trying to play some Warzone with buddies and friends and stuff like that. I've been kind of like dabbling with Warzone a little bit more on the channel. You guys may have noticed that already, so I would love to have you guys come, you know, play some Warzone with me, become part of the community we're building as we are venturing into Verdansk and what the future will hold for Call of Duty Warzone moving forward. It's kind of crazy, even with all of the different leaks that we've received from data miners that, you know, I really don't usually cover on my channel. There's plenty of really good content creators and people that decide to cover that kind of content, but we've gotten so much information that pretty much since Warzone has come out, and we still don't really know for sure what could be coming up in this event. Obviously, I feel like it's going to be transitioned into Season 3. We know Season 3 is coming up for Call of Duty Warzone as well as Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War. And I still feel like Verdansk, you know, while it has had some zombies added to the map, we've seen some Black Ops Cold War weapons added to the game, you know, since the game's release. And, you know, some of them have been overpowered. There's been all kinds of issues with that. Some people love it, some people hate it. I still feel like this map is very Modern Warfare themed. It doesn't have a Black Ops feel. And I've wondered, you know, will we get various points of interest, or are they only going to set it back to a 1980s time frame of Verdansk or something, you know, that would fit more of a Cold War era? You know, I don't really know what to expect. There's a lot of different speculation out there, but that's not really my type of content that I cover, like I said. So I am really, really curious what we're going to see in Season 3 of Black Ops Cold War and Warzone. I would love to know what you guys are hoping to see in Call of Duty Warzone and Black Ops Cold War moving into Season 3. So be sure to let me know what you're hoping to see going down in the comments. For me personally, there's a few things I want to see. I'd like to see some new points of interest, or obviously the map getting updated or changed to kind of spice things up just a little bit, to kind of throw some of those players that play all the time and they have their knowledge of the map, like their backhand, kind of, you know, set them out of their comfort zone a little bit and just mix things up. Outside of the general map changes, some things I would really like to see, it would be something more towards updating the game and allowing an FOV slider for consoles to kind of increase your field of view. It's, you know, especially since I play on PS5, not having a console option to increase my FOV slider whenever I have it in Black Ops Cold War but not Warzone is incredibly annoying. I have the feature on Black Ops Cold War. The PS5 is capable of handling it. I would love to see that become an option in Black Ops Cold War, especially for the newer generation consoles. In addition to that, I personally would love to see the Dark Aether camo get added to Warzone as well. You know, for me, I grinded Dark Aether camo in Black Ops Cold War. I slayed the crap out of some zombies for days worth of playtime, grinding all of those weapons, doing all of the challenges, getting them leveled up. And, you know, not being able to use them in Warzone is kind of a bummer. So I'm really hoping that with some of these teasers, we've seen some zombies related things going on in Warzone. I'm hoping that, you know, maybe something Dark Aether portal zombies related might be tied into this whole entire map change or update that will make using Dark Aether reactive camo in Warzone well accepted. It would fit the theme of the game or the environment of what's going on, and I would be able to use a super dope reactive camo that I spent a lot of time playing for here in Warzone as well. Let me know what you guys think. Would you guys like to use Dark Aether camo in Warzone for those of you that have it? I definitely think it's a must, and it's something that absolutely needs to happen at this point, I believe. In addition to seeing a few of those things come into Warzone, I think some other things I would like to see changed up a little bit. I would love to see the fast time to kill get slightly adjusted, maybe with you know, how strong some of the weapons are. I would love to see the Rose skins get dialed back just a little bit. Everyone in the game is running Rose skins right now. It's hard to see them in shadows in darker areas of the map. So I feel like that's something that's incredibly annoying that I hope to see changed up just a little bit. I would love to see the cheaters get prevented from playing the game a little bit more. Maybe having a proper anti-cheat in Warzone, that could be a huge thing. I know we see a lot of the tweets, you know, every couple of weeks about Raven and Activision banning, you know, 10,000, 13,000 accounts. I think I saw a tweet from Charlie Intel the other day that said at this point they've banned up to over, I don't know, 475,000 accounts at this point or something like that. But the thought to me is I would love to see it be more proactive than reactive, prevent them from doing it from the start. And the fact that so many of these accounts are free accounts because Warzone's free to play, I almost wonder how many of those are doubles, triple, quadruple made from the same person, you know, even if the person's made 10, 15 accounts, you know, like how many repeat offenders are there out there as well, you know. It's just kind of frustrating for a game that could have so much success. I really hope that they can make some of the improvements to increase the quality of life for the players. You know, people don't want to run into hackers and have their experiences ruined by that stuff. I would love to see something like that have a big focus, especially from the Activision side. They do a lot of great things, and I would love to see them kind of address that up front instead of just banning people that have already ruined other players' experiences in Warzone. So that's kind of just what I'm hoping to see right now. I did want to let you guys know about this event, what's to be coming here in the next week or so. I'm going to be covering everything over on Twitch and on YouTube as well, along with any possible weapon updates, new weapons, meta changes, class setups, any kind of news that I can bring you guys. So if you guys have enjoyed this video, if it was your first time checking out my channel, make sure you guys click the thumbs up button, leave a like. Make sure you guys do subscribe and turn on post notifications. Would love to have you guys become part of my community moving forward. And if you guys do happen to use Discord, there's a link to my public Discord server down in the description of this video as well, along with all of my other social medias that you are welcome to follow me along on. I'll be posting everywhere that I can about everything that I can. So guys, thank you so much for checking out this video. I really do appreciate it. We'll catch you soon for another live stream or video. With that being said, we'll see you next time. Have a great one. Peace.
Gas is closing. Get to the new safe zone. Just the 25 was still standing. Not that one, but we'll come back stronger next time.